Okay, welcome to this short paper. I'll try to keep it short. Perhaps I'll talk too fast. Just raise your hand and wave. It's about two projects. One of them you may already know, The Riddle of Literary Quality, which started in 2012, ended in 2019, in which we in Amsterdam tried to find out what makes a novel highly literary. What should it have to be considered to be perceived as literary by the readers? We combined different approaches to do that. On the one hand, a large survey asking actual readers to rate the novels, and on the other hand, the same novels we gathered in digital form and we analyzed them, searching for linguistic patterns. And of course, we then correlated the opinions by the readers with the stylometric measurements. That is a very interesting project. I'll tell a little bit more about that later, but it was followed up by a UK project together with my co-author, Sebastian Groes. Together we lead the project Novel Perceptions Towards an Inclusive Canon, in which we, in a way, replicate the Dutch research. So what we did was we also selected a corpus of 400 novels. We did it the exact same way for both projects. The survey in the Netherlands was done in 2013. The one in the UK was done in 2020 to 2022. So we selected 400 novels that were first published in the 5 years before the survey and that were most sold and most borrowed from public libraries in the 3 years before the survey. But the surveys were 7 years apart. When we compare, because comparing is what I'm wanting to do today, the corpora, we see quite comparable distribution across genres. So romance took up 10% in both corpora, suspense took around 45%, literary novel about 37-38%. So quite comparable corpora. Gender of the authors of these corpora, in the Dutch it was quite equal between male and female authors and a slight selection of others. What is remarkable in the English corpus of the most sold and most borrowed novels from the 3 years before the survey was that female authors dominated. They were much more prominent than in the Dutch corpus, which is very intriguing, I think. If we look at this per genre, the three main genres show very different patterns. It was comparable for suspense and romance, but not for the literary novel. So the prominence of female authors was mostly in the genre of literary fiction or general fiction. Then look at the respondents of both surveys. The Dutch survey has almost 14,000 respondents. The British survey had a bit over 6,000 respondents, much less than in the Netherlands, but hey, the times were different. There was a pandemic going on. But if we look at the gender of the respondents, it's quite comparable in both countries. More than 70% were female respondents, much less male respondents. So again, that was comparable. Looking at the age distribution, also quite comparable with a slight difference in the Dutch survey on the left with a dent around 35, 40 years of age where people were less represented in our respondents there. We did other comparisons that I won't go into here, but I'm zooming in on what these respondents thought, their opinions about the 400 novels in our corpora. Again, per category, per genre, we see that there is a comparable ranking in both corpora. So the UK readers and the Dutch readers both did not think very highly of romance novels. They got the mean lowest scores. They also agreed that literary fiction or general fiction received the highest scores, were most valued for their literary quality, and suspense novels were in between. So the same genre hierarchy can be found in both surveys in both countries. Zooming in on the top 10 most literary and the top 10 least literary in both surveys. On the left hand you see the Dutch top 10 with only male authors. Julian Barnes at number one, The Sense of an Ending, received the highest ratings, and he had received the Man Booker Prize the year before, so prestige abounded. On the right-hand side, you see the top 10 for the UK, with a lot of female authors in here. And again, Julian Barnes with another title, which is also interesting, and some other Booker Prize winners, for instance, The Sellout by Beattie, and Evaristo, Girl, Woman, Other. So here we clearly see differences between the two countries. Least literary, in the Dutch bottom 10, 50 Shades of Grey was reigning. And the other nine, all 10 were by female authors, and the other nine were then characterized as being chick lit, which we would now describe as humorous romantic novels, not using that term anymore. On the right-hand side, there are some comparable things, all female authors, E.L. James with another 50 Shades kind of title on the list, almost at the bottom. But what's different from the Dutch 10 bottom is that on the right-hand side, you see a mix of representations from literary fiction, romance, and suspense. So that's different from the Dutch lowest 10. Then, I'm rushing through this perhaps because this is my, I still have three slides. Then we compared the texts themselves. We measured a couple of features that you see on the left-hand side. We counted the number of paragraphs, the number of sentences, the number of words, tokens, the number of types, different words, different sentence length variation, sentence length mean, sample type token ratio, raw type token ratio, and the paragraph length mean. And this is a measurement that compares all 400 Dutch and British and English novels. It is sorted from based on the UK corpus, the English corpus, with the negative correlations on the left to positive correlations on the right. The blue line connects the measurements for the English corpus, and the orange line connects the dots for the Dutch corpus. And I'll talk you through this. So if we look from left to right, it says that for both corpora, the higher the number of paragraphs and sentences, the lower the literary valuation, the lower the score for literary quality. And then the horizontal axis is no significance. Then we, so for words, number of tokens, it doesn't matter very much. And then we go above the zero line. Number of types, different words, is for both languages a bit above normal, so it is statistically significant. And then things start to differ. So for both languages, the sentence length and mean sentence length and sentence length variation and sampled type token ratio are significantly correlated with the ratings for literary quality. But for the Dutch, sentence length was way more significant than for English. And then further to the right, they were comparable as to raw type token ratio and paragraph length. So this is for all together with the four different main genres. And I'll finally zoom in on only the literary novels. And then we see something interesting, I think, that could not be seen in the overall representation. Everything on the zero axis is not significant. So only for the English corpus, the negative correlation of number of paragraphs and sentences correlates with low literary quality. And then we see a difference, again, for sentence length is significant in Dutch, while type token ratio is significant for English. And of course, that sets us thinking, why is this different? So does it have to do with the different languages? Does it have to do with different conventions about what should be seen as literary, or is there a time difference, 7 years between the two corpora and between the two surveys? So a lot to think about. So let me sum up the main results of this first comparison. We found similarities in respondents as to their age and their gender. The corpora show equal genre distribution, and also the opinions about the corpora are quite comparable. But we see differences in the prominence of female authors between the highest and lowest mean ratings per categories, and difference in which text features correlated most clearly with opinions. So this is not finished yet. We have worked for years and years. So our next steps could be look into the temporal difference. Our ideal is that we should redo the survey at the same time in the same countries, but also in many more countries, to compare what the outcome would be across the world, as far as I'm concerned, and also explore then the underlying reasons for the similarities as well as for the differences. So we're thinking about looking for funding for a really, really big project, and we're looking for partners from other countries, from other language areas, who would be interested in joining us in that, and that should include all of the above. Thank you.